Hello, my name's Rick, and you're very welcome to this liturgy, which is bringing you together with young people from across our Catholic schools here in Hartlepool. Pope Francis wants us to reflect on the story of St. Paul when Jesus says to him, "Arise and bear witness." So in this short liturgy, we're going to see a dramatization of that story. We're going to hear from Father Michael and young people from across our schools. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is a reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
Saul kept on trying to hurt the Christians. He decided to go to the city of Damascus and find believers to arrest. He wanted to bring them back to Jerusalem and put them in jail. He took some soldiers and started to Damascus. As he travelled, something strange happened. A brilliant light shone down out of heaven, and a voice said,
"Saul, why are you trying to hurt me?"
Who is that?"
Saul stammered.
"I am Jesus, and you are acting like my enemy."
"What should I do, Lord?"
Saul asked.
"Arise, go into Damascus and wait for instructions,"
the voice said. The soldiers with Saul heard the voice but didn't see anyone. When the light and the voice were gone, Saul realised he was blind. Then the Lord spoke to Ananias, a disciple in Damascus.
"Go to the home of Judas, who lives on Straight Street. Ask for a man named Saul of Tarsus. I've told him you will come and give him back his sight."
"Oh Lord, I'm afraid to. Saul is a terrible enemy of all believers. He's here to arrest us."
"Don't worry. I've chosen him to be my messenger, not only to Jews, but to Gentiles, even to kings."
So Ananias obeyed. When he found Saul, he said,
"The Lord has sent me so you can receive your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit."
And that is what happened. From then on, Saul was a faithful follower of the Lord Jesus and preached about him.
As you reflect upon this National Youth Sunday, I know that you've been thinking about St. Paul, who became that tremendous witness to the gospel of Christ through that experience on the road to Damascus. And as he tells the story for himself in the Acts of the Apostles, he reflects upon how on the ground he heard the Lord speak to him, inviting him to get up, inviting him in getting up to be prepared then to witness to him and to reach out in the world of his time, as we're all called to stand up, to get up, having been baptized into Christ, fed and sustained with his word and in our Eucharist, for us all to recognize our call to witness to the Lord.
Thank you, Father Michael. To close, we're going to hear from right across our schools the six challenges that Pope Francis gives all of us of the ways that we can rise up and shine the light that God's given us with all that we meet. Let us close in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Today Christ speaks to you the same words that he spoke to Paul. Arise, do not remain downcast or caught up in yourself. A mission awaits you.
Arise, uphold truth, integrity, human rights and justice in today's society. Protect the persecuted, the poor and the vulnerable, those who have no voice in society like immigrants.
Arise, tell the story of when you two were blind and encountered the light. You two have seen God's goodness and beauty in yourself, in others, and in church, where all loneliness is overcome.
Arise, bear witness that lives can be rebuilt, that people who feel spiritually dead can rise again, that those in any kind of prison can once more be free, that hearts full of sadness can rediscover hope.
Arise, share joyfully that Christ is alive. Spread his message of love and salvation.
Among your friends, at school and in the university, at work, in the digital world, everywhere.
Arise, show all the people who know us, that love and respect are at the centre of the way we love each other. When we speak to our parents, the elderly, of those younger than us, may we share words of love in the lives of all we meet.
Arise, bear witness to the new way of looking at things that enables you to view creation with eyes of wonder, that makes you see the earth as our common home and gives you the bravery to promote harmony in our environment.
Never forget that anyone who has truly experienced God's saving love does not need much time or lengthy training to go out and proclaim that love. Every Christian is a missionary to the extent that he or she has encountered that love of God in Christ Jesus. Paul Francis.
If I make a mess, your love for me is evergreen. It will not change. I never, ever, ever have to run away. Even if I make mistakes, you hold me close, you whisper hope. Your love won't fade. We can all rise up and shine, 'cause you paid it all a thousand times. We are all